music for this dance performance is called Song of Rainbow Skirts and Feather Robes. The dance was the best-known court dance in the Tang Dynasty. The music was reportedly composed by Emperor Xuanzong and the dance choreographed by Yang Yuhuan. The dance was once lost, but now has finally been restored.
已经于都在神武其神了，就是说有一个道士啊，就带了唐明皇去月宫，唐玄宗就到月宫了，到月宫看几百个美女在跳舞唱歌。The
emperor was greatly impressed with the dreamlike dancing and exquisite music. When he returned home, he could recall the first half, but not the second half.
The structure of the song is like this. 没有这个，那不行哦，啊！于是正好杨金树就来献曲。The
Tang Dynasty reached its apex under Emperor Xuanzong. This is known in history as the Kai Yuan era. Emperor Xuanzong was a good musician as well as a good ruler. He not only set up the Office of Imperial Music, but also personally directed performances. Yang Jingshu, military commissioner of Xiliang, developed a musical score for the Brahmin Song, a popular tune in the Western region, and then presented it to Emperor Xuanzong.
Yang Jingshu 送了这个，正好是他如破以后需要的，都一个。
激烈的舞蹈的一个高潮，舞蹈这时候才进入。有一个确凿的消息，文献记载上有的，就是在那个天宝十三载，他们修订那个乐曲，就是把游戏那个乐曲的名字啊都改掉，婆罗门他就改为这个泥然鱼。
Various sources indicate that the composition of Song of Rainbow Skirts and Feather Robes was closely related to the Brahmin Song from the Western region. In a book on the Song Dynasty, the author, Jiang Xiaoyu, investigated the origin of Song of Rainbow Skirts and Feather Robes. Tang Dynasty records concerning the Western region state that the king of Kucha and local musicians were inspired to compose music by the sounds of the mountains. Later, some of their music spread into central China, including Song of Rainbow Skirts and Feather Robes. This confirmed that the song was composed in present-day Kucha. In this deep and serene hollow, countless crystal drops from the moss-covered cliffs converge into a mountain spring, called by the locals the Spring of a Million Tears. According to the biographies of eminent monks of the Song Dynasty, there was a place in Kucha where falling water produced a tinkling sound that was gradually incorporated into a piece of music.
你会听见咚咚咚咚咚咚咚咚，就那个泉水从上面往底下个窝窝流。哎，完了以后一会儿风来了，呜呜。
The sounds of nature became an important source of inspiration for Kuchar musicians to create the Brahman song, which was later dedicated.
这首诗证明什么呢？是一个真实的生活的体验。
这个手很有意思，这个手我们一般人可能做不到，这样翻过来了。另外呢，就是这样的手的姿态都很奇特，就作为秋思舞的一种动态。
Wang Xiaoyun, the choreographer for the Xinjiang Song and Dance Ensemble, has been doing research on Xinjiang dances for the past several decades. She has visited Kuchar and Baicheng many times, searching for traces of Kuchar music and dance in the wall murals.
北京艺术研究院的董希九老师，他到新疆来采风，给我们那个厅党委书记讲说，你们新疆有宝，你们怎么不去挖？就说克孜尔千佛洞，后来那个我们书记把这个事儿又告诉我们，然后我们就何旭初老师、周吉作曲家现在已经去世了，我们三个组成一个研究小组，就奔了克孜尔千佛洞。
Kizil caves were carved out of the sandstone hills, 35 kilometers southwest of Kuchar. Playing a variety of string, wind, and percussion instruments.
This is called 天宫祭乐。它只露大半身，磕膝头，磕膝头底下都是砖，都是天上人间是隔开的，底下是人间了。完了以后。这是天宫的祭乐人，拿着乐器，拿着各种舞姿。
Over 28 different musical instruments have been identified in the wall paintings in the dance scene and Buddhist tales. The music and dance performance shows that music and dance thrived in Kuchar.
它有101窟，101窟在山上， 那个是董希九老师先发现，那有一个武神，说你们去看看。好，武神，他是全裸，但是身上有很多璎珞彩带把他就包起来，他头上有个光环，是个女神，然后手，这手是这样子，刚才说的那个比较典型，很多体态都是他这样的，随便往那一站，他都是跨出去了，然后头往这边，然后膝盖往那，就是一个 S 型。
Wang Xiaoyun carefully examined the music and dance performance to learn the moves of the Guja dance.
We normal people dance is very rigid. He, bang, he just put his leg out. This position good or this position? You feel comfortable. Let's go out. This kind of thing. Understand? Put your eyes on, put your hand on. Let's put it together. Stand, stand, stand. Also, these kind of moves. Another, turn a circle. Look, this hand is here.他的脚步很多，有碾步、垫步啊、跺步都给他揉进去了，但是体态始终注意这个三道弯。我觉得这样可能就抓住秋子舞的他的动态特点和他形态特点。
The Kizil Caves has over 80 caves with wall paintings.50 of which depict music and dance performances. These Buddhist dancing scenes probably reflect secular Kucha music and dance. We can make them reasonable conjectures based on these images. Over a century ago, a painter arrived at a small town in Kucha.One evening, he heard some music that was like the sound of nature. He followed the sound and came upon a group of dancers and musicians. Spectators spontaneously joined in their performance. Later, the painter repeated this scene in the wall paintings and devoted them to his favorite deities.
这个六十步顶部攀道的是普格兹门乐器，这个乐器是人不奏乐，但是它自行奏乐的一种乐器的组合。这个乐器总共有十三种，不光是这个洞窟出现，类似的题材的那个十三窟也有出现。
This area has witnessed war, natural disasters, and famine over the past century. These instruments are either no longer extant or have evolved into different instruments.
Now, some instruments, for example, the flute, we can analyze, maybe they have become today's violin.
像比利现在日本还有，太小，现在匈牙利还有。
另外鼓手鼓了，现在是。
它对于这个周边国家影响也很大，像日本、朝鲜、越南，它也当时也用了秋子乐的一些东西。
Music is a type of language that crosses national boundaries, ethnic tensions, and many other obstacles. It's a sort of international ambassador, if you will. One day in 568 AD, a huge wedding party was traveling toward Chang'an. The bride was Princess Ashina.Daughter of Muchan Khan of the Turkic Empire. and she was marrying Yu Wenyong, Emperor Wu of the Northern Zhou Dynasty. Since Princess Ashina loved music and dance, Muchan Khan organized a song and dance performance with 581 AD, the Northern Zhou was succeeded by the Sui Dynasty. Su Jipo left the court and earned his living playing for the public. Then, an important event called Conference on the Music of the Kai Huang period of the Sui Dynasty in 584 had a profound impact on Su Jipo's career.
公元584年，隋高祖啊，他到皇帝的第二年了，人家一个大臣啊，去告诉他，就是说宫廷的这个就雅乐啊，就是不是音律不太好，啊，是不是应该要修整？啊，那个隋高祖听了嘛，也同意。那么说，你们找一批人去问去弄弄看。
But the musicians assigned to revise the court music were stuck in their ways.And failed to make any headway after 7 years of effort. The emperor was not pleased. One day, Zheng Yi, one of the court musicians, was thinking about how to add a high voice in one piece of his music. Suddenly, he heard the sound of a pipa. He found Su Jipo playing the pipa in a tavern and was greatly impressed with Su's music.
郑毅发现了跟那个中原的音乐就是不一样，这就是说切身之中啊，三声怪音。
It was these strange notes that helped Zheng Yi resolve his problem with the high voice. Su Jipo helped Zheng Yi quickly work out some new music theories.
郑毅呢，他还蛮用心的，就苏子武教的切字乐理的基础上。有发展，他发明了就是他个84调。
Zheng Yi's musical reform was highly praised by the emperor. It was the start of the new music system based on Kucha music theory that influenced the development of all Chinese music. Su Jipo is therefore known in history as a master of ethnic music.Naturally, there are no recordings of the music of the time. But those rock wall images are a great inspiration for the imagination. A 1903 expedition led by Japanese explorer Kazuo Yotani excavated an inconspicuous box under a Buddhist tower.In the Subash ruins in Kuchar County. No one would have guessed that that ordinary looking box held such a huge secret. In 1957, it was suddenly discovered that there were traces of a painting on the box.Removing the surface coating on the cover revealed a picture of four naked boys playing musical instruments and a group of dancers. According to Nobuo Komagai, a Japanese expert, the box was made in the 7th century, and the painting depicts the Kucha people celebrating one of the traditional festivals.
It's in the cold days, 11月左右，就等于是我们傣族的泼水节，往里是泼水，而且谁泼的一身都淋湿，那就谁好，运气好。有人在旋转，旋转衣服飘起来了，而且那个队伍是一个跟一个，一个跟一个，而且各种各样的面积。
The secular music and dance depicted on the box, meant to hold a monk's ashes, show that Kucha music and dance had become a part of the local Buddhist culture. In addition, the Old Book of Tang mentions that two Tang emperors enjoyed the celebration of such a festival, which is the same as a water sprinkling festival. Later, it became the name of a melody for poetry, which had a major impact on the traditional culture of central China.
大唐西域记，他说，秋词礼乐舞是管弦，特散诸国，就是说，那新疆那么现在是好很大一个新疆，其实我们也知道是很多很多民族，当时就是很多很多小国家，那么就是说，在这个。唐玄宗的时候，那还是他去取经的时候，他路过这个地方，他实际上实际考察了，考察了以后呢，哎，别的国家也都很乐舞都很兴盛，但是秋兹这个地方的乐舞，管弦伎乐特散诸国，就是比别人都水平高。
从头开始啊，宫廷里面设立七步乐，秋兹乐总归是第一步响当当。唐玄宗设立那个吏部记奉诸部的时候，还有秋兹乐。到了宋代教坊那个音乐里面，它还有秋兹乐，其他的都消失掉了。
The dance moves we see today are a reminder of when Kucha music and dance thrived.Because of the impact of Islamic culture on today's Uyghur song and dance performances, they differ greatly from Kucha music and dance. Nevertheless, traces of Kucha music and dance can still be seen in local performances. Elements of their song and music and dance have become part of newer styles over the past 1,000 years as different cultures clashed and integrated into the region. When troops defending the frontier went to save the emperor during the An Lushan rebellion, Tibetans took advantage of the situation to occupy the Heilong region. It left the troops guarding Kucha, including General Guo Xin, stranded and isolated. Tune in for part 7, Frontier Home, to learn their fate.